listening to this poem, you can go ahead and start marking the sensory imagery and figurative language that you find within it. And then we're going to go over some of that. So that's the first part of our goal. The second part, then we're going to write a poem inspired by this work. And I like listening to her read this. Yes, her name is George, and it is a female who wrote this. I think it really adds to the poem because you kind of get a sense of where her starts and stops are. And where they want the pauses to be. And so I like to listen to poets.
Where I'm from. I am from clothespins, from Clorox and carbon tetrachloride. I am from the dirt under the back porch, black, glistening. It tasted like beets. I am from the forsythia bush, the Dutch elm, whose long gone limbs I remember as if they were my own. I'm from fudge and eyeglasses, from Imogene and Allifair. I'm from the know-it-alls and the pass-it-ons, from perk up and pipe down. I'm from he restoreth my soul with the cotton ball lamb and 10 verses I can say myself. I'm from Artemis and Billy's branch, fried corn and strong coffee, from the finger my grandfather lost to the auger, the eye my father shut to keep his sight. Under my bed was a dress box, spilling old pictures, a sift of lost faces to drift beneath my dreams. I am from those moments, snapped before I budded, leaf fall from the family tree.
You thought it was monotone? You did. Really? How would you have read it differently? And that's a good comment. And I like your defense of that. The only reason I would disagree is that to me, it sounded like she was speaking a memory. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
good. The
only thing that differentiated her voice from Siri or a computer voice was the accent.
The southern accent.
And
there's a couple of things in here that I want to point out to you that you're probably not going to get on your own just from looking at it. First of all, is Imogene and Alistair. This woman, George L. Lyon, is from Kentucky. And Imogene and Alistair were two old ladies who lived on her street. Yes, Cody.
I wanted to make a comment about what they said.
Go ahead. I didn't see you.
It
I apologize.
It sounded like she cared about the pronunciation of the words, but not as much about putting emotion into what she was saying.
Okay.
And I just thought that I agree with Grant.
Cool. I'm glad that you can back that up with evidence as well, so it's not just... I appreciate that you're making comments and you're being able to add to it instead of just saying, I thought it was boring or something like that. You can actually say why. So Imogene and Alistair were people who lived on her street. There were two old women who, she just really liked their names, but she remembered that they were always sort of the ladies in the know who knew what was happening in her neighborhood all the time. Gossips, yes. And Artemis and Billy's Branch are both places in Kentucky. Artemis, I believe, is a town, and Billy's Branch is part of a river system. So let's just look at the first sentence together. Clothespins, Clorox, and carbon tetrachloride. What do we notice from that first, Melissa? Look at the sounds. And what is that example of? Who can help her out? Go ahead, AJ.
She did a lot of laundry.
She did a lot of laundry. Think about this. We're still talking about the sounds, though. Remember what that's an example of?
Alliteration.
It's alliteration. Thank you very much. Why do you think she used Clorox instead of just saying bleach. What's that?
It has a C.
Sure, so she wanted to stick with the alliteration. What else? But Melissa, what did you say? Okay. Think about what, my mother always used Tide laundry detergent, not the ones that you eat, but the containers. And if you go in a grocery store and you see Tide, what color bottle is it in? Do you know?
Orange.
It's an orange bottle. And you can always pretty much pick that out. Clorox is the same. Clorox has a certain symbol. And so maybe she was doing that for not necessarily a scent, like a smell. But what else could it be? Imagery, like what kind of imagery? The logo looks like, so there's a visual element there. Does anyone know what carbon tetrachloride is? Any chemists in here?
Yeah.
He says whitening clothes, what else? Because we were talking about cleaning clothes before. It's also something that's used in dry cleaning. And so if you've ever picked up clothes from a dry cleaner, it's got a specific kind of stink to it. And so I'm wondering if she link those together because it's all like, not only were there visual elements, but kind of a smell associated with doing laundry. So just in that one sentence, we found alliteration, we've seen visual elements, we've seen smells. So I'm going to let you go ahead and work, talk amongst yourselves. Smells, smell imagery, stink. Go ahead and talk to the people among you, and you guys can just go through this poem, okay? Again, I'm only going to give you about 5 minutes, okay? Don't delve deep into meaning. We're just looking for those elements of figurative language and sensory imagery.
Help your buddy.
Must be tall.
I think it does.